Super Blue Blood Moon, a rare triple treat up in the sky, celebrating America's first explorer in space. And Smoke and Fire, another Space Launch System engine test. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. The moon provided a rare celestial triple treat during a total lunar eclipse this week, and we were there to bring you the views on NASA TV and online. For starters, as the moon passed through Earth's shadow during the eclipse, it took on a reddish tint, a phenomenon known by some as a blood moon. It was also the second full moon of the month, commonly known as a blue moon, and it was the third in a series of supermoons, which made it appear closer and brighter than usual. NASA and the U.S. Air Force commemorated the launch 60 years ago of Explorer 1 during a Florida ceremony at the historic launch site.
On January 31, 1958, the attention of the American people was focused on Cape Canaveral, Florida, as a giant rocket was catapulted toward outer space.
The orbital satellite was America's first foray into space exploration. Explorer 1's primary science instrument led to the discovery of what we now call the Van Allen radiation belts that encircle Earth. On February 1st, another test firing of an RS-25 engine flight controller at our Stennis Space Center in Mississippi. It was the second such test in just over 2 weeks, and also was the third test of a 3D printed part for the engine. Four RS-25s will help our Space Launch System rocket launch astronauts aboard our Orion spacecraft beyond Earth orbit. Our DC-8 flying laboratory teamed with a German Aerospace Center aircraft recently to study how different fuels affect a jet engine's performance, emissions, and contrail formation. The data could help us learn more about alternative fuels. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.